Morning, partner. Need for a gun now.
Hey, I like the headwear. Very fancy. Gonna be out of supplies before too long. Guess beggars can't be choosers.
They're gonna hang young Tom Davies. Your friend, the Marshal, hang him for being your friend and doing good in a bad world. Montez's boys gonna teach goodness a lesson, teach law a lesson, tell order it don't exist no more in this chaos of a world. They got him in Tumbleweed, and they're gonna lynch him, or they're gonna lure you in there and lynch all you. Guess you'll have to figure that out. Get! Come on, let's go! All right, it's Tumbleweed. I said that. Marshal Davies crossed the line when he killed Alfredo there. Killed him without due process. No judge or jury, just an executioner. He crossed the line and now Alfredo's men, they're crossing it too. When good folks break the rules, well, they should know that bad folks are just gonna break them worse. Now the executioner is himself condemned. I only hope this bunch waits a while longer than Davies did to carry out the deed. But he might already be done for when we arrive. Sure, we'll save him if we can. But if we can't...
You gotta help!
Listen here. These two men are killers. The worst kind of killers. The kind that hide behind the law. So today, Marshal Davies and Sheriff Freeman are going to get what's coming. Do it.
If I could do it, I'd kill him again.
Do it!
Tom!
Thank you.
We have to go. There's a wagon over here. Sheriff Freeman, old man Jones, get in. That's what we want them to think. When they give chase, you shoot them. All of them. We're riding to a place I know by the river. Come on, yeah! We'll take out anyone who follows us. Wait out the rest.
Close call, Marshal Davis. Your bad deeds coming back at you.
I'm grateful you bring these folks, old man, but you better shut up.
I wasn't sure about you, Mr. Jones, but then you went and saved my neck. Well, I ain't gonna make a habit of it.
All of you, thank you. I mean it, thank you.
Yes, thank you. I don't like requiring help, but this time I did. Marshal Davies, all of you, thank you.
Ain't that fine? I was thinking we should leave before Montez's ghost decides to pay us any further visits.
So you are a good fella, Mr. Jones.
Me? No, never. I just like watching what other folks is, that's all.
There's a word for fellows like you.
Wise? Is that the word? Come, Marshal. Help me get home. Been quite enough excitement for a clapped-out old fool, well past his best, for one day!
Friends, I'll see you again, I hope. But next time, under better circumstances, I trust.
Thank you. I'm so glad you came. Thank you.
It seems your efforts have not been entirely in vain, but have produced some rather surprising results. Well, not surprising, but...
Confusing. After castigating me as a widow, a harlot, a fool, a madwoman, anything and everything. Suddenly, shortly after we killed his brother-in-law, Amos Lansing wants to talk. He sent word via an intermediary.
Mr. Jones.
Even that crazy old fool said not to trust any of it.
Which is why we need you. You're to help keep Mrs. LeClerc protected during the meeting at Blackwater.
I shouldn't imagine they would kill us in broad daylight, but you never know. I never imagined they'd kill my husband, nor turn me into a fugitive. Anyway, friends, shall we go? Today may go any number of ways, but I want to make sure once the shooting starts... all of them end up dead.
One of you drive the wagon. The other, keep guard.
Thank you. All of you. This means... well, it means something. I don't know exactly what yet, but...
I don't think any of us think Mr. Lansing has become a saint, madam, but... perhaps we should hear him out.
Perhaps.
Would you kindly take us to Blackwater?
I do confess, this is a most strange appointment.
Like I said, I would be much more comfortable going as your emissary, ma'am.
And I said I wanted to hear what he had to say. So look him in the eye when he was saying it.
Is that all you want?
Let's just see. And stay by my side. Or you can look over the meeting from some bank. Remember, this is not just the man who killed my husband. He, his wife, and their child. All had a hand in pushing you away. And send me up with the challenge. You got a knife? Of course, you can
this way.
In the middle of town. Of course. Tells everyone he's the boss now. Keeps me from acting too crazy.
You can hide up on the roofs or stay down here. Just make sure we don't get killed.
Just make sure if we do get killed, everyone dies.
No, just make sure we aren't both killed.
Come along, Mr. Hawley. Good luck. And thank you.
They're here!
Watch it!
Can you get me some more tobacco?
Take this. I'll be back. Let's go. Well, hello, darling.
Good to see you, Mr. Lance.
You too. Jessica! How lovely to see you. Why, it's been a long...
A long time? No, it hasn't. Not compared with all eternity.
Oh, Jessica, I miss Philip every day. It's awful what happened to him. Quite terrible, but you seem... My dear, you seem under the misapprehension that I had something to do with his demise.
You, your wife, or your business partner, at least one of you did, and your brother-in-law. But he's dead.
Well, he was a bad man. I'm glad he was killed.
Sure. It cleans up your mess, doesn't it?
You don't seem quite well, my dear.
I'm not. I am destroyed with grief.
Oh, of course. Yeah, life can be terrible, but... Well, there is a business matter that we need to discuss.
Oh, sure there is.
Well, you see, he and I had an agreement. In the event one of us died, the other took control of the business in exchange for a nominal sum.
Oh, you lie, sir.
You signed. Last year. The document lies with Mr. Shaw there. He also has your money. $500.
My husband's property was worth 100 times that. You thief! You murderous thief!
Madam Leclerc, I will ask you to watch your manners. I have good standing in this town.
Oh, you do, do you?
I am a man of impeccable morality.
Oh, well, then you have little to fear of death. You god-awful swine.
Forged. Get the hell out of my sight, you pathetic lowlife.
All right. Critical ready. More coming. You can beat the others.
Stay down, man. We're not out of this yet. Shoot them when you see them.
Amos Lansing's dead. So these men are working for someone.
He may be dead, but his money isn't. Stay down, my lady.
I'm down, all right. Be careful, Hawley.
Careful as we can be.
I believe it might be.
That is not quite how Amos or any of those fools expected that parlay to work itself out. There we were, looking to find him and have our revenge. And he came right to us.
That he did, ma'am. But I think we would all have liked to know you were going to shoot him beforehand.
Ma'am?
I didn't know it myself until the moment it was done. What a fool Amos was. A man's presumptions about women. They can be their undoing, Hawley.
Indeed.
Did Jeremiah Shaw send those men after us?
No, I believe they were working for Mr. Lansing. I'm pretty sure this feud ended when you put a bullet in him.
I'm pretty sure it's up to the grieving widow and the folk here who were condemned wrongfully to die to say when the feud is over, Mr. Hawley.
Quite right, ma'am. Quite right. Of course. I was only...
Well, don't. When I want your advice, I shall ask for it. And I have not asked, have I?
You haven't.
This is a good spot. Pull up. I'll take it from here. Here are the documents, madam. They were forged.
Of course they were forged.
Here.
I don't need to see them.
No, I don't suppose you do. Although there's a...
There's Grace Lansing, but she will have to wait. And also, we have to decide how we're going to clear all our names and extricate ourselves from the mess we have uncovered.
Not sure the state authorities take too kindly to revenge killings, madam.
No, I'm sure they don't. But that's a problem for another day. Because right now, their little plot is over. And my husband has been avenged. My friends, my true friends. I owe you more than words can say. Thank you. And should our paths cross again, and... Well, I'm sure they may. But right now, I need to make myself scarce. And I recommend that you all do your best not to get into too much additional trouble. That's your business. My poor husband. He deserves so much better than this, but this is what he got. This is what we all got. Drive on, Mr. Hawley. All right. Etta Doyle. Used to be known as Madame La Pearl. She runs a gang of other fallen women, sticking up trains and coaches mostly, but seems to have a particular fancy for robbing Leviticus Cornwall of late. So his men have set a honeypot to lure her in. Tipped her off about a big stash of money and ammunition at Cornwall's freight yard in Saint-Denis. Asked if I can send some good bounty hunters their way. Just be careful. They play smart.
Looks like she only sent one.
Okay, we gotta move fast here. Come on. Now the bait's already been set. Etta Doyle and her girls could be here any minute. Mr. Cornwall, you don't want his name anywhere near this for reasons I'm sure you can understand. Just wants it dealt with quick and quiet. Gonna want to ensconce yourself in here. Now wait till they bust in, and then, when the moment's right, ambush Miss Doyle and escort her into custody.
They want her alive.
You get paid, we get rid of her, everyone's happy. Now don't worry about her cronies. She's the one with the price on her head. They're notorious for dressing alike. So you bide your time, you figure out which one's Doyle. You'll know for sure when you see her face. Got a big old scar down her right cheek.
And we're just gonna hang around and stand guard, create some semblance of security, and just pray the crazy bitch don't bust in and shoot us straight in the face. All right, now, it's time. Find a place to hide, and we'll wait for the guest of honor.
on a record, she's something special. She won't even come after me herself. That's because she ain't stupid. She ain't... Oh. Whatever price there is on my head, is that worth your life? I don't make empty threats. I will find you. I find everyone. But let me go now, and you'll never see me again. You have my word. And everyone knows, Editor lives and dies by her word. Don't try to act tough and ignore me. You think you've got guts? I'll show you your guts and make you carry them in your arms to hell. I'll teach you what pain really is. Things I've been through. Things all my girls have been through. We're cold to it. Believe me. We only rob those who deserve it. Evil bastards like Cornwall, who think they're God and get rich off of other folks' sweat and suffering. You want to put money back in his pocket? Because that's what'll happen if you go through with this. Fat man will get fat.
Unbelievable.
Thank you. rehabilitation might be beyond them, but we may hope. The runner's ours, so the bounty's yours. Right there for you.
Thank you.
Looks like a pretty rare fur you got on there.
Supplies are starting to run low,
just so you know.
Anything's better than nothing.
Excellent. Thank you.
Supplies are running down fast. This is good quality. I suppose this will do. Beautiful. Okay, this will have to do.
Thank you. object, don't we?
And just what do you need that gun for?
Welcome back.
Yeah.
You know, I'm getting quite used to having you around. That looks like an impressive belt.
Supplies are running down fast. This is good quality. Supplies are looking healthy right now. Good stuff. Beautiful.
You know me, I hate dogs, but it might be useful to get one for protection.